We normally talk about things in our videos that we actually do, and that makes good sense. In this video, we're going to talk about the things that we don't normally do, and hopefully it still makes good sense.
These are things that are not necessarily good or bad. In fact, some of the things that we don't do are to our own detriment. They're just things that we've seen other RVers do that we don't do.
One of the things that we see or hear a lot of RVers do or say that they do is stay at Walmart. This is something that we haven't done at all yet, not even once.
And that's not to say that we haven't stayed in store parking lots, because we have stayed at a Cabela's parking lot before.
And we've also stayed at casino parking lots. So, you know, it's not a value judgment on our part. It's just something that it just kind of seems like it, you know, it's a grocery store, a department store. It just doesn't really come up on our radar as some place to even, you know, stop for a night. Now, that's not to say that if we were in the situation that others are in, that we wouldn't do so, because we would. We would definitely stop at a Walmart if there was no other place for us to stop and we needed to stop. But typically, we're trying to stop at places that are going to, number one, be there for RVers. For example, the parking lots that we have stayed in have had various services.
Yeah, like Cabela's, they have actual designated RV parking with large spots. They had water available. Sometimes they have dump stations, you know, making it much more welcoming for RVers rather than Walmart. Just some of them just allow it, not really encourage it, I guess.
Yeah, and it tends to be in a kind of a more urban setting at times, and they're just not on our radar. It's just not where we want it to be adventurous, I guess. And the Cabela's, the times that we've stayed there, the stores tend to attract outdoor adventurers and travelers, and so it's kind of fits what we're doing. And we also buy things there when we're there. So they do cater to RVers. And the casinos, they're obviously got other motives for you being there, as do Cabela's. Yeah. They want you to shop there. And the casinos want you to go in and gamble. We're not too big on that. But we do like the fact that the casino parking lots have usually 24-hour surveillance and security patrols, and their signs stating RV park here, RV parking here. So that makes us feel good that we know that if we do get a knock on the door, it's probably some kind of courtesy thing, and it's not asking us to get out of there. And so that's really nice. And then we don't do that very often. I think we've only stayed in the Cabela's twice in 5 years. So it's not anything that we try to do. But anyway, we haven't stayed at a Walmart yet.
Something that we've seen other RVers do that we don't do is to strap things to the ladder on the back of their RV ladder. Things like other ladders, lawn chairs, bicycles,
kayaks, things like that. We've seen all manner of things. I guess the primary reason why we don't do that is we just like to stow everything. And they're probably okay weight-wise. I mean, it is supposed to handle, my weight on the ladder. And so putting a couple lightweight lawn chairs on there, maybe even a light bicycle or something, light aluminum ladder, shouldn't pose a problem in theory, I guess. But also, I don't think the ladder would like it much if I were hanging on it while it was going down the road, because then the weight is actually going up and down with force, creating a totally different spec for usage. So the primary reason is we just want to stow the things, though.
Yeah, because if it's visible, it's a bigger target for theft. If you're parked somewhere and you have, some nice bicycle strapped on the back there, it's going to be a lot easier for somebody to be tempted to take those, rather than if you have them covered and stowed in a different manner. Yeah.
Another thing that we don't do is park too close to others. And this is something we don't do whether we're in the truck or the RV. We've been doing that for many years with our automobiles. We tend to park out far away, primarily because we don't like it when people hit our vehicle with carts and with car doors. And it tends to happen a lot. We see it happening to other people quite regularly, so we tried to avoid that. And we don't mind the extra walking, so we'll park out a bit. Now, the funny phenomenon that takes place is we can be in a just wide open parking lot with cars up close to buildings for convenience, and then no one out in the South 40, let's say, where we're parked, and we're in a big black truck, and we'll come out and there'll be three other big black trucks parked around us, and I think that might be some kind of social psychology thing going on. But
I think that that's also part of what happens with RVs as well. If you pull into a place and there's no one around you and another RV comes, rather than, you know, leaving a little space and parking a little bit farther away, they'll think, oh, this must be where RVs are supposed to park, so they'll come and park right next to you.
Yeah, so. And I think a lot of times it is just a mindless thing or a courtesy thing that they, or maybe even a permission thing. They think that that's where you're supposed to do it, and they're just kind of following suit. Mm-hmm. But it does get a little bit strange at times, and you wonder why people park the way that they do. But I think for the most part, people aren't trying to be, malicious or whatever, or just, you know, intentionally bad to you or have wrong thoughts. But it does happen. We have friends that contact us quite often with photos or video clips telling us, can you believe this, how they parked? And it is kind of hard to believe sometimes.
Another thing we don't do is have a satellite TV or subscription service.
Yes, in the beginning we decided that we didn't want to have too many costs hanging over our heads, and when we started looking into things, it was another $100 a month or another this or that, you know, for fees, and so we just decided early on that we weren't going to do it. And this became very easy for us because we're all about the outdoors and adventure, and this has basically become the way of life for us, so we haven't missed it at all. Now, that said, we do watch programs from time to time, and sometimes we'll stream from things that family share with us, or we'll go to the library.
Yeah, just check out DVDs. Sometimes there'll be some local TV that you can get just with your antenna, and that's fine. And this is just something that we noticed a lot 5 years ago, mm-hmm. when we first started doing this, when some of the streaming subscription services weren't as widely available, is that a lot of people seem to have this satellite dish set up that we just didn't want to do.
Yep. Putting our slides out when we're hooked up is another thing that we don't do.
And this is primarily because of a fear that I have of the physics of how the slides work. I'm just afraid that if you're not level and you put the slides out, there's a chance that they could bind and get stuck and not go in or not go out. And yeah. It's just a fear that I have. We've seen people do it several times and apparently not had any problems, but it's something that we just don't feel comfortable doing.
Yeah, and our specs for our refrigerator say that we're not supposed to put or have that running when the RV or the slide that it's in is not level, because that could pose problems for the refrigerator. Now, this may vary with different rigs and different refrigerators, but it's just something that we don't do. Another reason why we don't do it is it's when we're on the go and we're just stopping for an overnight or maybe even a couple nights, we don't want to bother with putting all that out and back in and unhooking and all that kind of stuff unless we have to. And we can pretty much access everything that we need without putting our slides out. For example, we can access our shower, our toilet, our sinks, our bed, and anything that we have problems with getting to that we're aware of, we try to have those things out and accessible for that amount of time. For example, we can access half of our refrigerator, so we make sure that we put things over on that side when that slides in, and Susan will get some other things out for the dog and for us to snack on and that kind of stuff that we'll need readily.
Something that we don't do is boondock or dry camp for extended periods of time. There's a couple reasons for this, and one of them has to do with the fact that I'm kind of spoiled about having water. I'm not very good at rationing water and taking 30-second showers and rationing the water for washing the dishes and making it last for long periods of time.
Yeah, and we do have a rig that can hold a lot of water and everything. And it's not to say that we're not the kind of people that would do that sort of thing or that we don't like doing that sort of thing. It just hasn't really fit into our adventure schedule because we're going different places. If it was our objective to go out somewhere boondocking to stay there and just kind of hunker down out in a place, we would certainly make do and learn to ration and do the kinds of things that we know to do. We just don't prefer to do it that way. Another reason has to do with our electric, primarily for Barkley, our dog. We like to keep him cool and feeling good, and so we use air conditioning. And solar has been one of those up and down issues for us. We completely put it on hold when we first started RVing. It was something that we got to the point where we thought, we could probably do that, and talked about getting it again. And then the more that we watch the way that we do things, the less that it's needed. And that's primarily because we tend to be in places that are either very warm and it just wouldn't power our air conditioning without an enormous setup, and we just don't do that type of camping, if you will, that requires that substantial of a setup. And the other thing is that if we're not out in the open like that in the sun and in that heat, we tend to be in the wilderness under the trees. And in doing that, we're hiding from the sun, so we're not really open to a lot of solar. So that's kind of the whole thing.
Yeah, we've used a generator. Again, I'm not really a fan of generators. They're noisy. You have to carry gasoline with you. Just, again, something that we choose not to do.
Yep. This one's about using camp chairs or camp rest, that type of thing. That's something that we don't do, at least don't do enough of, and
right.
We could learn from others, because a lot of people
do. Yeah, we see a lot of people just chilling in their camp chairs, and unfortunately our camp chairs have been packed up for over a year and haven't even been out of the packaging that we keep them in when we travel.
Yeah, we just recently got them back out. I do have my hammock out. This is one of those things that we're usually on the go quite a bit. We're out exploring and doing things, and we actually did a video on rest, one of our beach talks. You should check that one out. That'll give you a little bit more background on this. But we're certainly believers in rest. We know how important it is and how vital it is to health and well-being. And it's something that we try to do, especially when our bodies are telling us that we must do it. So this is something that we're working on, and we will try better at doing. We want to get in those chairs and rest. And for me, I love just laying in my hammock. So we put that up, and so that's something that we're going to try to do. We see almost everybody that we know or hear of that are RVing. They sit around in their camp chairs and relax, and we'd love to know how much you get to do that.
Yeah. As we said in the beginning, we're not saying doing or not doing any of these things are good or bad. We simply wanted to share some of the things that we don't do. So please comment and let us know if there's things that you don't do in your RV life. And please remember to share, subscribe, and click on that little notification bell.
Thanks for watching.
So tell me again, why do I have to be strapped to the ladder?
Because a lawn chair can't tell me what it's like to bounce up and down going down the road. Don't worry, I'll check on you in a couple hours. I'll pull over.